variations on magnetic flux. Here the situation is I am placing a uniform cylinder in the uniform magnetic field. Now trying to find magnetic flux linked with the different surfaces. Here the magnetic field which is acting along x-axis, its value is constant and the direction is also constant. We can call it as a uniform magnetic field. This is uniform magnetic field along x direction. In this field, now set a uniform cylinder in this manner. Now the cylinder has three surface areas. Give different names. This is the first surface area, name it as A1. We have the second surface area, name it as A2. These two are circular surface areas or the flat surface areas. The third one is there, which is the cylindrical surface area, name it as A3. If you look at this pen, it has got three surfaces. The cylinder is like this one only. Here is the flat surface A1. Here is the second surface A2. The curved surface, this one, the total curved surface, named it as A3. Now if you see, these lines, magnetic lines, are passing through this cylinder. Now, try to find how much is the flux linked with the surface A1. I'm using the formula Φ1 is equal to B into A into cos theta. Here A is, you should take it as A1. Now how much is the angle between B and A1? First, we need to assign the direction for the aerial vector for this surface. As I told, the aerial vector is always perpendicular to the surface. Now the question arises, either we should take towards right or towards left. If an object contains more than one surface, conventionally we should take the aerial vector direction is in the outward direction. That means towards the left direction. So we got the aerial vector is in the outward direction to the surface area A1. Similarly, for the second surface A2, the outward normal comes towards right. This is the direction of A2 vector. And for the curved surface, the aerial vector direction should come in the vertically upward direction. At every point we can take the direction is vertically outward direction. It is not the upward, we can say it is in the outward direction. So on the top the outward is up, on the bottom the outward is in the downward direction. So these two represents the direction for the A3 vector. Now the angle between B and A1, if you see, the B is along x-axis and A1 bar is along the negative x-axis in this direction. The angle between these two is 180 degree. So in place of theta, but to find Φ1, keep the value 180 degree, which is equal to B A1 cos 180 degree. How much the value cos 180? Yes, it is -1. So which is equal to minus B into E1. We got the negative value for the flux S. But the definition of flux, phi is equal to B bar dot A bar, it is the dot product of two vectors. We know the nature, it can be positive, it can be negative, it can be zero. Because the flux is operated by the cos of angle. We know the cos value fluctuates from 1, cos 0 is 1, and cos 90 is 0, and cos 180 is minus 1. So how the cos value changes accordingly, the flux value will take a negative value, positive value, and sometimes 0 also. We got here negative value. Now, try to find the flux linked with the second surface, phi 2, which is given as B into magnitude is A2. The angle between B bar and A2 is 0 because both comes along the x-axis. You can write here cos 0, which is equal to B into A2, and the cos 0 value is 1. You can write here 1, that is equal to B A2. You got here positive value for the flux. So phi 1 is negative and phi 2 is positive. The third surface is there, which is phi 3, given as B into A3 into cos of. Now you see, A3 direction is outward throughout the third surface. And this line makes an angle 90 degree with the B bar. See clearly, this is A3 bar, outward direction. And B bar along x axis, the angle between these two is 90. Right here, cos 90. And if the cos 90 is 0, the whole result comes as 0. So phi 3 is equal to 0. So phi can be negative, phi can be positive, and phi can be 0. Okay. What is the total flux linked with the entire body? For that, we need to add all these fluxes. So total flux is equal to phi 1 plus phi 2 plus phi 3, which is equal to phi 1, we got it as minus B into A1, and phi 2 is B into A2, and phi 3 we got it as 0. That is equal to, you see, as I told, this is the uniform cylinder, which means that magnitude of A1, which is equal to magnitude of A2, because they are flat surfaces. By taking this consideration, you will get minus BA plus BA, which is equal to 0. We got the result, the entire flux linked with the total cylinder, which is equal to 0, which means that how many field lines are entering from the first surface? The total lines are leaving from the second surface. So within the given time period, no field lines are not linked with this surface. And if you see, no one line is passing across the outer surface or through the A3 surface. We have just completed the concept of magnetic flux. Now let us see some numericals related to this concept. We have the question. Let us see the question. A magnetic field of induction 20 cos is passing through an area of 20 meters square, which makes an angle 30 degree with the plane of the surface. Find the magnetic flux. In this question, the key part is that the magnetic field makes an angle 30 degree with the plane of the surface, which is not given with the aerial vector. Now we have to find actually the angle between the magnetic field intensity and the aerial vector. Let us first draw the diagram related to this question. We have got surface area like this, which is given as 20 meters square. This is the surface area which is given to us. And through this surface area, a magnetic field intensity of this much value, 20 cos, is passing through it. Makes an angle 30 with the plane of the surface. Now let us draw the magnetic lines of force passing through this one. Makes an angle 30 degree with the plane of the surface. You see here, this line I am taking on the plane, so we can call it as plane of surface, POS, plane of surface. But we need normal line or the aerial vector. So let us draw the one line which is perpendicular to the surface in this way. It comes as the aerial vector. And this is the direction of the magnetic field intensity. If you know the angle between these two, then you can find the flux very easily by using the formula phi is equal to BA into cos theta. Now tell me, shall I take the angle theta as 30 degree here? It's not at all, because this angle is given with the plane of the surface. So in the diagram, it is very clearly mentioned the plane of the surface, which is along the surface, that makes an angle 30 degree with the magnetic field intensity. So, to calculate theta, it is a very simple relation between these two. We can write theta, which is equal to 90 minus 30 degree. It comes as 60 degree. So, what we need here is 60 degree, not the 30 degree. So, substitute all the values in this expression. You can find the flux, which means the number of magnetic lines of force which are passing through this surface area. Tell me how much B is given here? 20 cos. Shall I take directly 20 cos? No. We are trying to express the answer in terms of SI system. You must convert all the given values in the SI system. So B has 20 into, and tell Gauss in terms of Tesla, because Gauss is the unit for magnetic induction in CGS system, but we need the value in SI system. So the relation is 1 Gauss, which is equal to 10 to the power of minus 4 Tesla, and take the value here 20 into 10 to the power of minus 4 for magnetic induction into area of cross section is given as 20 meters square. Directly you can take 20 into cos theta. Theta is given, actual angle is given 30 with plane, but we found the angle between A bar and B bar which we need. We got it as 60 degree. So take it as cos 60 degree. That is equal to, see, 20 into 20, it comes as 400. Into 10 power minus 4 into cos 60 value is 1 by 2. If you solve this one, you will get 200 into 10 to the power of minus 4, or you can write it as 2 into 10 to the power of minus 4 Weber. And the answer you got, the flux passing through the surface area is 2 into 10 power minus 2 Weber or Tesla meter square. We have a second question, which is a magnetic field intensity 15 Tesla is passing through an area formed by vertices A, which is 0, 0, 0, and B, 5, 0, 0, and C, 0, 0, 4, and D, 5, 0, 4, making an angle 90 degree with the plane of the surface. Find the magnetic flux. You see, in this question, the area is not given directly. We need to find out by using the vertices which are given. Now, the position of A is at the point 0 comma 0 comma 0, which means it is at the origin. The point B, which is 5 comma 0 comma 0, is on the x-axis. The point C, 0 comma 0 comma 4, is on the z-axis. And D, 5 comma 0 comma 4, is on the x-z plane. And this field intensity passing through this area makes 90 degree with the plane of the surface. But we need an angle between magnetic field intensity and the aerial vector. It's not the 90 degree. So we need to find that also. And finally, with this information, we can calculate the magnetic flux. Let me write the formula for magnetic flux, which is given as phi is equal to B into A into cos theta. The B value is given directly, which is B is equal to 15 Tesla. So no problem with B value. But area, with this information, we can find the area by taking the Cartesian coordinate system, which is x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. Now locate all these four points in this Cartesian system. The point A lies at the origin. You can take here 0, 0, 0. This is the point A. The point B is on the x-axis. You take somewhere else the point B on x-axis. The coordinates are 5 comma 0 comma 0. The point C lies on z-axis. We have here z-axis. This is z-axis. You take some point here. Name it as C, given as 0, 0, 4. The last point D, it lies on x-z plane. Somewhere you take the point here and name it as D. The coordinates are 5 comma 0 comma 4. Now join all these points, you will get a surface in this manner. It's been looking like a rectangular surface. We know the formula to find the area of rectangle, which is given as A is equal to length into breadth. How much is the length? It is obviously 5 meters. The breadth you will get, which is equal to 4 meter. That it comes as 5 into 4, which is equal to 20 meters square. So with the given information, we got the area of the surface as 20 meters square. The third part, the angle, theta. With the plane, the angle is given 90. So with the area, it comes as 90 minus 90, which is equal to 0 degree. I can represent here. First, let me draw the plane of the surface. This comes as the plane of surface. Here you see, this line is on the surface. And the normal line, which is perpendicular to the surface, something you can draw like this. It is named as A bar. Now, the magnetic field intensity makes an angle 90 with the plane, which means B is passing along the direction of aerial vector. There it comes as 0 degree. You see this formula, theta is 90 minus the given angle, where the given angle is with the plane of the surface. Now substitute all the values here in this equation. You will get flux. Phi is equal to B is given as 15, and here you got it as 20. The angle is 0 degree, which means cos 0 degree, which is equal to 15 into 20. It comes as 300. The value of cos 0 degree is 1. It comes as 300 Weber. Now we have the question number 3. A coil is set in YZ plane. A magnetic field is passing through the coil normal to it. Find the change in flux when the coil rotates an angle 180 degree from its initial position. Initially, we have to set the given coil in YZ plane. Let me explain. Initially, the planes with the help of this disc. You can see here clearly, if I place this plane or a disc on the board, it comes as XY plane. If I turn 90 degree in this direction, it comes as XZ plane. One more time, if I turn this one 90 degree, it comes in the YZ plane, which means that in this question it is given the coil is set in YZ plane. So keep our coil in this orientation. The same thing I can draw on the board. Like this. And I'm giving the names to the circumferences. The one is towards me, another is away from me. Towards me it is named as A, away from me it is named as B. These are the circumferences names. Now draw aerial vector for this coil. It is perpendicular to its surface. This comes as the aerial vector. And the plane of the coil is passing through its plane in this manner. It is along the plane. This is called as the plane of coil. A bar is the aerial vector which is perpendicular to the plane of the coil. Now the magnetic field is passing normal to the coil, which means along the aerial vector. Now this comes as the field direction B bar, which is fixed. Now we are rotating this coil of an angle 180 degree from its initial position. Now you see, this is the coil. You can see only the circumference of it. It is named as A. The other circumference is there, it is named as B. You can see only the part A. If it is rotating with respect to which axis, that is the most important. If I rotate with respect to the geometrical axis, there will be no change in the flux. You see, the field lines are passing along x-axis does not change with this rotation. So to make the change of magnetic flux, this coil has to rotate along diametrically in this manner. You can see. Now it is being rotated 180 degree with respect to the diametrical axis. Initially, the aerial vector is away from me. With respect to me, it is away from me. Or we can say it is along x-axis. This is the aerial vector. Magnetic field is also in the same direction along the x-axis. By keeping the magnetic field constant, turn this coil 180 degree. Now the direction of aerial vector comes along negative x-axis, but the magnetic field direction is again along the x-axis. Now the angle between magnetic induction and the aerial vector changes with its initial angle. Now initial angle is how much? Theta 1 is equal to 0 degree. The theta is the angle between B bar and A bar, which is 0 degree. Now this coil is being rotated with 180 degree rotation with respect to plane of the coil. So it comes in this manner. The face which is nearer to me now comes as B. Away from me comes as A. And the aerial vector becomes along negative x-axis. And the direction of magnetic field, which does not change, initially it was along x-axis. Now it is also along the x-axis. With this rotation, the new angle comes as theta 2 is equal to 180 degree. Our interest is to find the change in flux. Let us write the change in flux delta phi is equal to phi 2 minus phi. They can expand phi 2 is B, A, angle between these two is 180 cos 180 minus the initial flux B, A into cos 0. The initial angle is 0 and the final angle is 180. To find the change in flux, just we need to take the difference because flux is a scalar quantity. It doesn't have any specified direction. Directly we can go with the subtraction, the final value minus initial value. Then you can take BA is common. BA is taken out. Cos 180 value is minus 1 and cos 0 is minus 1. Then it comes as minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2. So minus 2 into BA. So it comes as the change in flux. The same manner, for a different orientations, we can find the change in flux. The most important thing is that if this coil is rotating with respect to its geometrical axis in this manner, this is the rotation with respect to the geometrical axis. With this rotation, there will be no change in the flux. In which way we have to rotate? About its diametrical axis in this manner. Now the coil is rotating about an axis passing through its diameter. And the field direction is along the x-axis. With this rotation, we will see with respect to time, there will be a change in the flux. Sometimes you will get the flux is maximum when the aerial vector is along the direction of field. In this orientation, the flux is zero because the angle between B bar and aerial vector is 90. Again, the aerial vector is towards me. The angle between B bar and A bar in this case is 180 minus BA. That means negative flux. One more rotation, you will get again 90. Means that the flux is zero. In this way, the flux is changing by the rotation of the coil. The same principle is being used to generate electricity in the AC or DC generators. We can see these things in detail in the coming sections.